Today on BRStv, we have our sixth episode of the Neptune Apex series. In this episode, we're going to explore the display unit. Hi, I'm Ryan, host of BRStv, where each week we go over something related to reefing. In today's episode, we're going to explore the display. Well, it's nice to see a visual display how everything is doing. I'm gonna be honest, you can use a display to program basically everything. It's just a hell of a lot easier to do it in the browser of a PC or Fusion. For the purposes of this video, I'm just gonna forget that and show you around. You start with what's on the display by default, which is date, time, temp, pH, ORP, and amp usage. A bunch of icons that indicate what's currently turned on and off. If you take the time to assign each icon, remember each one, and the different states, this can be useful, but a lot of people will start their Neptune experience by turning them off and reducing the clutter on the interface. Something we'll show you how to do later in the video. Quick overview of what each button does. From the home screen, the top three buttons, including the up arrow, do nothing. The left and right buttons cycle through different home screens. You may have the desire to set up different screens to see different elements or tanks. The down button initiates a feed cycle, which depending on how you have it set up, might turn off your return to keep food from going down the overflow. Also common to turn the skimmer off for an hour or so. If you hit the down arrow or feed button from the home screen, it will show feed mode A. You can cycle through the different feed modes by hitting the button and waiting for it to initiate. If you hit the feed by accident, just want to turn it off, hit it again and select the same mode and it will display the seconds left. Hit the cancel button and everything will turn back on. The center button is both a menu button as well as enter button. Push it once and it will bring you to the main menu. This is a good time to discuss button mashers. The system is designed to make things quick, which means if you hold it down, it will register it as a series of quick selections. When I say hold it down, I mean if you tap it more than half a second. Let me give you a quick example. From the home screen, tap on the menu or enter button once and it brings you to the main menu. Tap on the first selection, which is Control/Status, then tap again on the first selection, which is the feed mode, and boom, you've activated the feed mode. If you're a button masher and you hit it hard from the home screen, the Apex basically measures that as holding it down and immediately cycles you all the way to the end of that and triggers the feed cycle. Now, if you knew the menu structure, like the back of your hand, that might be helpful, but I think we could have a pretty healthy debate if this is a helpful feature for the majority of users. I only bring it up because if you're having problems navigating the menu system, it's probably because you too are a button masher. Okay, so back to the main menu. From here you have Control/Status, which is another area where you can trigger the feed mode. Manual control allows you to cycle through all of your outlets. Say you had a hot date over and you wanted to show off the tank, but the daylight cycle was done. This is where you'd scroll through all the outlets, find the lights, change them from auto to on. Feed cancel is pretty self-explanatory. If you want to turn off a feed mode that's running, this is another way to do it. Module status lists all the modules running in their current state. You can see here my WXM firmware is old, which means I have to update it. Something we'll probably do in a future episode. The last option says display lock with the option off or on. If you want to lock the display because you don't want your kids mashing the buttons or otherwise messing with the controller, this is where you do it. Be aware the moment you turn it on, the system is now locked and you're no longer going to be able to do anything unless you know the password. I'm sure the password is somewhere in that 140-page user guide, so you can find it there. However, I'll save the effort and just tell you that it's XYZ. Enter that, hit OK, and you'll be in. Going back to the main menu, you'll see data log, which is basically graphs of your tank parameters. If I hit it, I can see a chart of my temp, pH, ORP, or even power usage. The left and right buttons allow you to scroll through the different days. The power log tells you when the last power outage was, and the log interval dictates when the controller takes readings. Probably not something most people will change, since most people don't need a finer look at tank history than 10-minute intervals provide. The last option from the main menu is setup. This is where the heart of the programming will be done if you are going to do it from the display. I'm going to reiterate at this point, if you program your entire Apex from the display like this, it's because you're an absolute glutton for punishment. It's a billion times easier using the browser interface or Fusion. For this video, I'm going to skip this process of explaining how to program outlets, profiles, and modules because it deserves its own video. But if you know this is what you want to do, this is where you do it. The pH, temp, ORP, conductivity, and dissolved oxygen setups are primarily areas where you would calibrate and enable features for each probe. This is one of those things that's actually easier to do using the control pad because you're at the tank when you're doing this and there's no internet latency issues to deal with. Now we're going to go over calibration process with each one of these in some episodes coming up very soon. Clock setup is pretty self-explanatory, more or less just setting up the time and date. The networking and email setup are one of those things that people have the most challenges with in a somewhat advanced topic. This absolutely deserves its own video down the road. I will say when this video is shot, cloud-based Fusion was days to weeks from being released. Once people move to Fusion, this area will become much less relevant. One thing I'd like to point out is the IP address option. This will display the current IP address of your Apex. If you type that number into your internet browser that's on the same network, it should bring up the browser-based configuration system. As I mentioned a second ago, Fusion is just around the corner and about to be released, so the browser-based configuration will probably be something most of you won't be using very soon. Next in the system menu is a display setup. The home display is an area I promised we'd come back to. Go ahead and select the home display and then select page one. This is where you see various lines you can enable or disable. I'm going to disable the last two, which are the outlet icons, and save. Now my ORP and power usage are much larger on the home screen and easier to read. Say I had a PM2 and wanted to see my salinity on the display homepage rather than amp usage. I can do that by selecting the probes line 2, the right one which is currently amp 3, and switching it to conductivity which is the salinity probe. I could also make it even cleaner by turning that line off. This is also where the other home screens come in. Say I had an Apex running multiple tanks. I could use page 2 through 4 to view them from the display. I could also set up a second page to show some secondary things like the pH of my calcium reactor, or maybe I was using a second temp probe to measure the ambient temp of the room or hood. Display password allows you to change a password on your display from XYZ to something else. Honestly, I'd leave it as is if you can because the password screen defaults to Z and it's increasingly large pain in the butt to type in the password the further you get from Z. By setting daytime, you can change the brightness for the display to be brighter during the day and dark at night, which might be nice if your tank is in your bedroom or somewhere else you might like it to be dark. On systems running the latest firmware, Apex Fusion will be the next option in the main menu after system. If it's functioning properly, it'll say okay and I know I'm in good shape. Self-test runs a script which presumably runs a short test of functions, tell you the current version of firmware you're running on, and serial number. So if you have any questions about how best to use the display or advice for fellow reefers, check out the comments area down below. If this is your first time with us, hit that subscribe button because we do this every week. See you next week with another episode of BRStv.